All right, so let's move to the next one. This one. Should I do it? See, here you will have this angle as 30 degree because of reflection. So like that, you'll get this angle to be 60 degrees. And similarly, you can get this angle to be 60. And then this also becomes 60. So you'll get equilateral triangle. So every time you'll get equilateral triangle only. Fine. Every time you'll get equilateral triangle. So you can see that each equilateral triangle is occupying this much length. Okay. Which is how much? Which is equal to the side length of the equilateral triangle. Which how will you find? I have this length. This length I have to be equal to 0.2. So in this right angle triangle, I can get the side of the equilateral triangle, which is this, to be equal to 0.2 divided by cos of 30. This is the side length. Okay. So A will come out to be 0.2 divided by root 3 by 2. So this is 0.4 divided by root 3. Is this thing clear? Okay. Now let's calculate number of equilateral triangles. So in 2 root 3 meters, number of equilateral triangles will be equal to 2 root 3 divided by 0.4 divided by root 3. Okay, this will be 6 divided by 0.4. Okay, so 5 and this is 3. So you will have 15 equilateral triangles. Fine, you'll have 15 equilateral triangles, and every equilateral triangle, you'll see that every edge of it represents one reflection. Okay, so if there are 15 equilateral triangle, then you may tend to think that 15 into 3, as in 45 reflections are there, but then you'll see that this reflection, this one, this one, all these reflections are counted twice. Okay, so if you just count 2 reflections, as in suppose this equilateral triangle you count only 1 and 2, then this equilateral triangle you just count 3 and 4. So per equilateral triangle, if you count just 2 reflections, then you will be covering all the reflections. Okay, so hence number of reflections will be equal to 15 into 2, which is 30. Okay, that is why option number 2 is correct over here. All right, now you may see that towards the end, this will be the situation where the last equilateral triangle, this one, will be one of the possible reflection. Okay, where it will get reflected and go away. All right. So answer is actually 30 or 31. But then 31 is not in the option, so that is why option 2 is correct. Any doubt, guys? Anything? This is more of, I think, geometry question, or more of mathematics question than the physics one. In case you have any doubts, please type in. We'll move to the next one. Start solving this question. I'll upload another one. These are the last 2 questions for today. Going to be 7:30. Okay, are you getting 32nd option 3? All of you? See, angular position is defined as, suppose this is the point for which you need to find angular position. Let's say this is the point. this point's angular position is this angle. Fine. That's how you define the angular position of a point on the screen. Okay. Now, if theta is the angular position, do you know that the path difference between these two is nothing but d sine theta? Okay, which can be approximated to d tan theta as well. Fine. So let's say that the path difference between these two is d sine theta. Okay, now intensity has to be 1/4. So intensity formula is what? I is equal to 4I0 cos square phi by 2. Okay, 1/4 of the maximum intensity. Now maximum intensity is 4I0. So 1/4 of that is I0. So you can find out the value phi for which I becomes equal to I0 by using this formula. Okay, so you will get cos of phi by 2 to be equal to plus minus 1 by 2. Now plus minus 1 by 2 actually represent one point above and the other similar point below. So we'll just focus on the point above. So I'll just take the positive value over there. So pi by 2 should be equal to what angle? Phi by 2 will be equal to pi by 3. Okay. So the phase difference should be equal to 2 pi by 3. Fine. If phase difference is 2 pi by 3, what be the path difference? Path difference should be equal to lambda by 2 pi into phase difference. That's how you convert between phase difference and path difference, right? So this will be equal to lambda by 3. Fine. Now d sine theta, if you equate that to lambda by 3, you'll get theta is equal to sine inverse of lambda by 3d. That's why option 3 is correct over here. Fine. Now try out question number 33. Some of you might have class to start at 7:30. I guess for those guys who are from Kormangla, NPS Kormangla, they can leave this and join that mathematics class. Okay. This is anyway getting recorded and this just problem solving. So please join that. All right. Anyone? 33. No one. Should I solve it? Okay. Let me solve it now. So I'll just briefly discuss this question. Probably then I'll leave it after that so that you can also do it your own. Okay. So first of all, PC is a wavefront. So P and C are the points on the same wave. Okay. Hence, P and C are in phase. Phase of P is equal to phase of C. Okay. Now what happens? This point C moves forward, get reflected and reaches P. Okay. So between this ray and this ray, okay, the path difference is CO plus OP, and because of hard reflection, lambda by 2. This is the path difference. Okay. So always take care of the reflection also. When there is a hard reflection, lambda by 2 you should add. All right. Now CO and OP you can find out. OP is what? This angle is theta. Okay. So this D is given and here it is 90 degree. So OP, you can write it as D divided by cos of theta is OP. Okay. And once you get OP, you have a 90 degree angle here as well. You can get CO as well. CO is OP cos of 2 theta. Okay. Which is D by cos theta into cos of 2 theta. Cos of 2 theta is cos square theta minus sine square theta. Okay. So you can use all that and then just substitute the value of OP and CO in this particular equation. And you need to have a constructive interference over here, right? So for constructive interference, delta x should be at least equal to lambda. So you can just put the value over here as lambda and then just simplify it and you will get the answer. I'll tell you the correct answer over here. 30th, the correct answer is this. 33rd. Okay. Fine. So that's it for today from my side. So we have tried to cover many different aspects of optics today. So I hope you will now be able to revise optics in a more efficient way. And if some question come in competition, you should be able to get it. But then again, you know, at times it may happen that a very difficult question can be put forward in the exam. So it's okay that you have studied optics, you know, very nicely and you're not able to get the answer in the exam. So don't fight with the question paper. Just leave it if you're not able to solve in couple of minutes. So there are, you know, total 30 questions in physics. So you can attempt others. But then having said that, there is a big, there's a good probability that easier questions will be asked from optics. Okay, fine. So for today, you can like the session and then leave it. Bye-bye.